Good evening. This is Pastor Jacob Snyder from Beacon of Unity Church. Welcome to the Lighthouse. Happy New Year. This is a wonderful season full of hope, new direction, desires, New Year's resolutions, daily resolutions, monthly resolutions, people trying to get out of debt, people trying to lose weight, people trying to pay off bills. And people trying to reignite and reunite relationships. And in this time, I just wanted to drop a nugget tonight. As I was thinking about the new year, a scripture came into my spirit. And this is the scripture. In Matthew chapter 6, verse 33, Jesus is teaching the Sermon on the Mount. And this is what he says. He says, "But seek first His kingdom and His righteousness, and all these things will be added to you." You see, we can have all the goals and we can have all the energy and we can have all the desire to get things done. But if we forget about Him, then we're usually going to fall short. It says, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness." So what Jesus was saying, look, I want you to be blessed. I want you to have a good year. I want you to get out of debt. I want you to have a great family relationship. But first, you've got to be kingdom-minded. You've got to seek the kingdom. You've got to be in God's will and direction. A few weeks ago, when we were talking about the true meaning of Christmas in Isaiah, he says he's the wonderful counselor, right? Well, in that wonderful counselor, he's there to lead you, guide you, and direct you. And so for this new season and this new year, put him first. Seek the kingdom, right? Then secondly, it says, and his righteousness. He's saying, look, it's time for you to be sold out for me. It's time for you to be holy as I'm holy. It's no longer playing the fence. You know, on Sundays, I'm going to be a Christian. And Monday morning, I'm going to be a heathen. You know, you can't do that. He's saying, I got to have you sold out for me. So we got to seek first the kingdom, be sold out for Jesus. And then it says, and everything else will be added to you. So he's saying, let's get the first two steps done. You put it to me. Give me your time. Give me your energy. Give me your all. And then I'm going to hook you up. Look, God is a God of the hookup. He loves to hook you up. There's just that catch. Are you willing to sell out for Him first? Look, I'm a personal example. My life was jacked up. But then I gave it all to God. And Jesus hooked me up. And so tonight, I just want to say a quick prayer with you. Maybe you don't know Jesus. Well, it's the new year. What better way than to start off the new year than by knowing the Savior? Amen. And then maybe I'm just going to pray for wisdom and direction for some of you that God would help you through this new year and strengthen you. So if you want to know Him, if you've never accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I want you to just repeat after me. And we're going to ask Him into your life that this will be the best year ever. And for eternity, not just for the year, but for the rest of eternity. Come on now, that's some good stuff right there. Not just temporal, but eternal. If you want to know Jesus, repeat after me. Say, Lord Jesus, I come before you tonight. Lord, I know I'm a sinner, but I ask you into my heart. I ask that you would change me and save me and set me free. Lord, I want to put your kingdom first. And Lord, I want to be righteous as you are righteous. Have your way in my life. Change me and set me free. In Jesus' name, amen. If you said that prayer and you mean it with all your heart, you are part of the family, the kingdom of God. And I'm telling you, if you will just keep your eyes on Him, He's going to look after you. And for everyone else, Lord, I just pray right now that you would bless each and every person on the sound of my voice. That, Lord, you would be with them this year. And you would guide them. You would direct them. You would lift them up. And, Lord, I pray that, God, you give them Holy Ghost wisdom right now for decisions that they have to make in this year. Financial, family, job related, it doesn't matter. I pray for wisdom and direction in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray that you would give people strength to put the kingdom first. I pray that you would give people strength to be righteous and holy, Lord God. And Lord, we rebuke addiction, we rebuke sickness, and we pray for healing right now in everyone's body. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, this is once again Pastor Jacob Snyder. I wish you a wonderful, happy, blessed New Year. And until next time, God bless you.